September 2nd here at Nelson Outfitters. Jim and I are sitting off the same big alfalfa field that we were on yesterday morning, just in a different spot about 500 yards away from where we were. There's a fence that runs off the field, comes down and crosses this little stream right here, and you can see the big trail that comes by at 15 yards. And if they're on the other side, it's only like 25 yards, so we just gotta get lucky that one of those bucks decides to leave the field and come down through here. So, Jim killed a really nice mule deer last night, so I'm up to bat now. My dad and Whitley are hunting a little bit down the river from us, and it's a beautiful morning. It's a little warmer than it was yesterday, and we already had a couple does come by, so we're just gonna sit tight. Hopefully a good buck decides to leave that field and come down this fence this morning, so we'll see what happens.
Shoulder. We're gonna be able to see him coming for several hundred yards and should be good. It's really hot tonight, so don't expect him to move till the sun goes down, but usually when the sun goes down it gets pretty exciting up here. So well, it is day three here at Nelson Outfitters, September 3rd, and we are in the Beamer blind today. This is a blind that's been here for a long time. Keith Beam is the one who picked this spot, and there's been a lot of deer shot right here.
this corner is gonna fill up with shade here in the next couple hours. And the alfalfa is really nice and lush out in front of us. So I think tonight's gonna be a good night. And hopefully we can get a shooter to come over that hill and come right down here by us just like last year and give me a shot. So fingers crossed, we'll see what happens. Whitetail coming right now, and he's probably 70 yards walking right at us, so hopefully this is the one. In a row, same blind, me and Jim.
Yeah, buddy.
Just smoked a really good buck at 40 yards. That deer came in earlier and he went up here and bedded down, just like that 7x5 did last year.
Yep.
And then my other buck came in and I shot him. We never knew where he went. They just went up there and laid down. He came back out and I don't think he was gonna get any closer. And I smoked him at 40 yards.
All right, well, we just got out of the blind. We're gonna go up here, take a look at the arrow. We saw him go down, so the blood trail doesn't really matter, but can't wait to go get my hands on him. I've never killed a velvet whitetail before.
All right, well, there he is. Night 4 at Nelson Outfitters. We actually killed him out of the same blind. I killed my buck last year on the same exact night. And it couldn't have worked out any better. This buck came out pretty early and he came by us and went up, and I'm assuming he went up there and bedded down for probably over an hour. and we were starting to think it wasn't going to happen. All the deer were getting further away from us, and looked back up there. He stood back up, came down on the field, and I had to make a 40-yard shot on him. I don't think he was going to get any closer, and he only went a little over 100 yards from the blind. So got to thank Steven for hauling us around and putting us in these spots. Dave and Jan for having us out every year. This is one of my favorite hunts of the whole year, and it's a good way to kick off the season. This is my first velvet buck, velvet whitetail ever, and he's a dandy. He's got a lot of character, good mass, and I'm pretty happy with him. So Dad and Whitley are up. Me and Jim are gonna split up tomorrow now, and I'll probably be filming Whitley. Dad and Jim are gonna go, so we got one day left, and hopefully we can fill two more tags, but pretty awesome night here at Nelson Outfitters once again.